Well, this opening hand seems fine. We can play Springleaf Drum on turn 1, then turn 2, well, a bunch of more artifacts. Yeah, this is definitely a good one. We might also threaten a very quick Ingmoth Nexus kill, which is a plus. Yeah, that doesn't really change things. And I play Springleaf Drum, not Vault Scourge, to play around. Well, first of all, like Lightning Bolt on the Vault Scourge, but also early on, it's more important to just get the mana artifacts in play. I don't need to stop in my upkeep. So now it's important to sequence things to get through some counter magic. Mana Leak, Spell Snare, and Remand are the main things to keep in mind. I would prefer not to get my Arcbound Ravager or Cranial Plating countered. If the Vault Scourge gets countered, then that's gonna be fine with me. So I will lead off with Vault Scourge. See what happens. If he wants to Spell Snare this, sure, then he spent the Spell Snare on nothing. Okay, it resolves. Well, Mox Opal would be next. No counters yet. I still want to play something at least, which means probably the card that I want to offer up to a mana leak or potentially Spell Snare still. And I think that's gonna be the Arcbound Ravager. Cranial Plating seems like the best one to have, especially with like double Inkmoth Nexus. So yeah. Let's play the Ravager. Actually, it's also surprising. Well then, add a drum because why not? Okay, well, if he doesn't want to counter anything, I'm obviously fine with that as well. So he might have been lacking red mana before this, and now he finally gets access to stuff like Lightning Bolt. Well, if I want to play around Lightning Bolt, then that entails putting the plating on the Ravager. If he then wants to bolt my Ravager, I can just sacrifice three artifacts to it. But at the same time, that means casting stuff before. Actually, I'll play the plating first, just in case he might have a mana leak. At least I can sneak it under the mana leak. To the Ravager. Then I can just attack with both. I'll bolt, I don't really care about that. It's gonna make a 4/4 Arcbound Ravager. Don't really need any of these Springleaf Drums. Well, Bolt Resolves, you got it. Course, it makes the plating a bit less effective, but still good enough. now, well, I have lethal on the next turn if my opponent doesn't have anything, which seems unlikely. Obviously draw one of the two cards in my deck that I cannot cast with this this mana in play. Oh well. So now I have to be careful of, I guess, Snapcaster Mage on Lightning Bolt, as well as Cryptic Command and, well, some other stuff. You never know what could happen. Restoration Angel. I think if my opponent has Cryptic Command and like bounces my Ravager, I'm just gonna sacrifice and put the counters on Vault Scourge. If he wants to tap down my creatures, then sure, that's fine. If he has some combination of bolts and blockers, then I just want to be attacking with the most creatures possible. So let's get in with this. Or try at least. So it looks like there is a Crypto Command coming. Return target permanent to its owner's hand on the Ravager. And tap all creatures your opponents control. Wait, maybe I actually have lethal here now. Because if the Crypto Command only has one target, and if the Ravager is gone upon resolution, then creatures are not tapped anymore. So let's do some quick math here. Yeah, I think I actually have him. I can put some counters on everything in response. So now I have 5 counters here. I have a 2-2 Vault Scourge, so I need to get 2 more counters, which I can get by sacrificing the Cranial Plating. So now we have a 6-6 Arcbound Ravager. And sacrificing, say, Ingvold Nexus. Then I sacrifice the Arcbound Ravager to itself. Counters on the Vault Scourge. Vault Scourge becomes a 9-9. And now Cryptic Command is going to be countered upon resolution. And I attack for 9. That's the game. So how to sideboard against like this blue-white-red mid-range or control deck, whatever it is. Galvanic Blast doesn't really have many good creature targets. I mean, blasting a Restoration Angel or something is sometimes fine, but I'd rather just have an additional artifact in my deck or some better interactive card. Steel Overseer is also not where I want to be. When the opponent has the Stony Silence, it doesn't really do anything. And it makes myself susceptible to stuff like Electrolyze, maybe Wrath of God if he has it. Forces me to overcommit. So it's kind of the worst 2-drop, I believe. Instead, I'll put in a random Blood Moon. It can sometimes steal some games. Double Edge Champion, because they have so much spot removal, and this is a good way to get past it. Let's see, 2 Thoughtseize, kind of a proactive way to hopefully deal with a Stony Silence. Not exactly reliable to play it on turn 1, but I have to try something at least. And for the last card, I mean, this is just selecting the least bad card from the remainder. It's going to be Spellskite. It can deflect Lightning Bolt, which could be useful. And submit.